All right, we're going to work on the water cool bricks here tonight. We got Mike over here. He's working on a water pump. I picked up a water pump, and he's just cleaning it up a little bit. Brand new water pump, and it has a little burr in it. So, we also got a little dirt bike.
Hey, Tubes.
All right, what are you doing with this thing tonight, buddy?
Well, we're not going to be using the whole coil and all that set up here, so I think what we're going to do tonight is we're going to cut this out here. And, so we'll just have this center thing, all this whole big backing plate. And and get the condenser and the whole armature and all that stuff out of the way, and start cutting.
All right. This normally this backing plate, you see the four bolts here. It bolts right up to that. It goes right into that hole, and it would distract from the engine. Hold that up, everybody. Yeah, it would distract from any engine. Plus, I thought we were getting away the thing. But anyway, we don't need all that since we're going to run a buzz coil on it. And it'll just make it look a whole lot better, so. All right, go to it, buddy.
All right.
He's just cutting the rough edges off, and then he's going to hit it on a sander.
Yep.
Get all that shit out of his way. All right, looks good, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
How are we doing over here, buddy?
Yeah, we're making pretty good progress. We just got a couple, probably
years.
About three or four more cuts to do, and then we'll be ready to just put it on the sander and be done.
All right. Looking good, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
Watch those fingers.
All right.
You about done over there, buddy?
Yeah. Put two hose barbs in it. And we're about ready to see how well this little thing moves water.
What did you do, just polish inside or something?
Yeah, well, what actually happened was there's actually four ports on this pump. There's two in the side, which are 1/8-inch pipe fed, and there were two in the back. I guess if this thing was going to be mounted on the side of a machine, or a casting, which had, you know, oil galleries in the block itself. So what I did was I drilled and I threaded them for a 5/16 thread and put two set screws in there. What I did was I stopped the tap prematurely so that the set screws would stop and that they would kind of wedge themselves in with a little bit of pipe sealant. What I didn't realize was that the wall of the pump in that area was fairly thin, so when I wedged them in, even though I didn't crank on them hard, they were just snug, that distorted the body of the pump enough that it was kind of binding the rotor a little bit.
Yeah.
So I backed them out and I went in there with some 1500 grit emery paper. And just kind of, I found the high spot, and I kind of polished up a little bit, and now it's moving freely again. So, okay. And as far as the set screws go, I put them in there with new sealant, a little bit lighter, and with the pump assembled, so I could tell where it got, before it got to the point where it was going to bind again.
Right.
So I think it's going to seal up well enough right now. If it's still a problem, we'll take them back out, and we'll put them in with Loctite, so we don't have to actually wedge them in.
Right.
But I don't really like Loctite that much.
Okay.
So I'd rather just have it sealed like that. So, we'll put some hose barbs in. We're ready to try it with some water.
Let me go get a bucket.
All right.
All right, ready to try it? Oh, look at that. That's actually pretty good pressure, Mike. Wow. Yeah. That's gonna be some good flow.
Oh yeah.
Wow. And how many RPM is that right now, Mike?
Well, I guess it tops at it.
We only got it hooked up to a drill.
1400 is we're basically 1400 right now.
Huh. Wow.
That's a lot of
water.
Yeah. I mean, in reality, you can have it at pretty much any speed you want, because it's going to be belt driven, so.
Right.
I mean, you could have it going like that.
That's probably what you want. You just want it to flow, you're not.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah.
For as much heat as the engine's going to produce, that will be more than enough water flow through the radiator to cool it.
Huh.
So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So what do you think? We'll go try to get a 1-to-1 ratio or something?
Well, I mean, if you're going to run the engine at like 400 or 500 RPM.
Probably. It's going to be idling most of the time.
Yeah. I mean, it'll be perfect, really.
Mm.
If you want to speed it up a little bit, that's fine as well,
Huh.
You know what? You're probably going to have to... You're probably going to end up having a larger pulley on the engine just because of the size of the crankshaft versus the size of the shaft and the pulley. You can put a small pulley on there Or you could put a larger one, you know, 1-to-1, you know, 1.25-to-1, you know, a little bit larger on the engine, just to give you a little bit more flow. But I think you're, in reality, you're going to be just fine. Interesting thing is the design of the pump, it flows, water flows the same, in and out the same course, regardless of what direction the pump is spinning.
That's pretty wild.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So it don't matter, you can mount that whichever way you want, it's still going to pump.
Right. Right, you just have to be mindful of, you know, which port you're using. So,
right.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. It's a neat
little pump. Cool.
Good quality pump. American.
All right, yeah, so I'm glad we picked that up. What is that, Tuthill?
Yeah, Tuthill from Chicago.
Chicago.
So, yeah, it's a neat thing.
Yeah, I like that. Okay, grab that other one, Mike. Show me whether I was going to use this.
Oh, man. I'm embarrassed.
It says we would have been embarrassed to put this on there, but...
Oh, man.
This would have got us working. Yeah, throw that out. Where's the chassis? Throw that out, Mike.
It's garbage.
All right. All right, let's get back to working the backing plate. Let me see what we got here. The kid's got it.
It's already to...
You're ready to sand it up.
So, give me a couple minutes and I'll have it ready for you.
All right, good deal, buddy.
All right, bud.
How's it look, buddy?
Looks pretty good. Turned out quite nice.
Yeah. Oh, that's plenty good.
Yeah.
And especially, I don't know if we're going to put the lid on it or nothing. Well, you know, I think we will because we'll put the lid on because we're going to have a flywheel on there too, so. Yeah, put that on, let's see what it looks like.
Take the dirt out and everything. But yeah, it's,
There you go. Yeah, if you don't put that on perfect, it gets cocked. That's how tight that is.
Yeah, that's how it's going to be.
Yeah, that looks good. Yeah. And we'll have our points on there and be good to go. Where's the plate? There. There you go.
There you go.
You're going to have that plate on there and then a flywheel, a little baby flywheel, so.
Yep.
Okay. Good job, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
All right. What are we going to do now?
I don't know. I guess maybe we could drill some holes in the head.
Drill some holes in the head. Yeah, we're gonna make a head out of that block of aluminum. Okay, I don't know how long this is, but I don't know if we'll put this on here or not. So let's go check.
All right.
What we're gonna do is transfer the holes of this head into this block of aluminum here, so we have something to start with. But I think it's getting kind of late. 8 o'clock. I think the kid's got some tests tomorrow. So what do you think, buddy?
I think enough of this.
Enough of this?
Yeah.
All right. Enough of this for now. All right. Later, tubes.
All right, tubes.